Don't forget to subscribe and turn the notifications. We upload daily, and check the source of this video to view all the images and videos if there was any. Labour was plunged into turmoil today after veteran MP Frank Field sensationally quit, blaming Jeremy Corbyn for making the party a force for anti-Semitism. Mr Field, 76, told party bosses that after nearly 40 years as a Labour MP he was quitting the party whip and will sit as an independent. Labour MP Wes Streeting warned the Labour now faces a catastrophic split as others will follow Mr Field and quit. In a letter detailing his decision made public tonight, Mr Field said Britain fought World War II to defeat Nazis, but under Mr Corbyn's watch that victory is being eroded. Scroll down for video. Frank Field is pictured in Westminster tonight after he resigned the Labour whip, saying he would sit as an independent and attacking leader Jeremy Corbyn over anti-Semitism, and in an interview with Sky News, he said he finally made the tough decision after former Chief Rabbi Lord Sachs accused Mr Corbyn of being an anti-Semite. Lord Sachs was responding to a video, exclusively revealed by Mail Online, in which Mr Corbyn told a meeting that British Zionists had no sense of English irony. Labour Deputy Leader Tom Watson said the resignation was a serious loss for Labour and must be a wake-up call for the party. He said, "It reflects both the deep divisions in the party and the sense of drift engulfing us. It is a major wake-up call. We cannot afford to lose people of such weight and stature," and Mr. Streeting warned that Labour is teetering on the edge of a catastrophic split, telling Sky News, "Frank Field isn't the first and I fear Frank Field won't be the last." Labour MP Lucy Powell took to Twitter to say that the party must do more to tackle anti-Semitism. The Manchester Central MP said, "I spent much of today speaking to local party members who had been in touch to say they were resigning. Some had been subject to anti-Semitism from other members. I managed to persuade most to stay, but we must do more to demonstrate we are serious about tackling this issue." Frank Field, 76, pictured on Sky News today, has announced his shock resignation from Labour's parliamentary party and blamed Jeremy Corbyn and the anti-Semitism scandal for his decision to quit. The move is a major blow for Jeremy Corbyn, pictured earlier this month at the Troxy in London, who has seen his party torn apart by the anti-Semitism scandal. Labour MPs have warned that others will follow Frank Field, causing a split in the party. Labour MP Wes Streeting warned the Labour now faces a catastrophic split as others will follow Mr Field and quit. Shadow Justice Secretary and Corbyn loyalist Richard Bergen said that Frank Field should be forced to hold a by-election so that voters can boot him out of office if they want to. Labour MP Siobhan McDonough paid tribute to Frank Field's work on Twitter after the announcement. Labour MP Neil Coyle hit back at Corbyn Easter columnist Owen Jones' claim that Mr Field jumped before he was pushed, and said he helped lift millions out of poverty with his work. He added, "I fear the political crisis facing the Labour Party now is the greatest we have faced since 1981. We have seen already this summer speculation of a split. I think this would be a catastrophic moment for the left in British politics. I think it would surrender the government of this country to the Conservatives for another term, if not another generation." On the Conservative side, Home Secretary Sajid Javid said, "First met Frank Field when I was 19 and he spoke at UNIF Exeter. Admired him ever since. We have our political differences, but he's a man of integrity and principle. Sad what Labour has become." Fellow Tory MP Marcus Jones said, "Frank Field is an honourable man. I was astonished at how a group of his own colleagues rounded on him so aggressively in an EU withdrawal bill debate. This looks like the final straw. Who is Frank Field MP and why has he quit the Labour parliamentary party?" Frank Field has led the charge in some of the most high-profile crusades against British businessmen in recent times. As chair of the powerful Pensions Select Committee, the veteran MP's most notable campaign was fought against retail tycoon Sir Philip Green over the collapse of BHS. Sir Philip owned the retailer for 15 years before selling it to serial bankrupt Dominic Chappell in 2015. It collapsed 1 year later, leaving in its wake 11,000 job losses and a £571 million pension black hole. An enraged Mr. Field immediately set about pursuing Sir Philip with the aim of clawing back cash for pensioners. After hauling the billionaire to Parliament and subjecting him to an hours-long roasting, and after a very public war of words, Sir Philip agreed to pay £363 million towards the pension deficit. More recently, Mr. Field has trained his guns on another corporate debacle, that of Carillion. The outsource's liquidation in January left a £900 million debt pile and hundreds of millions of pounds in unfinished public contracts, as well as a £800 million pension deficit. Mr. Field has argued that Carillion's pensioners, suppliers and employees have borne the brunt of its failure, while former directors and the firm's auditors have raked in millions. In characteristic tone, the MP for Birkenhead earlier this year savaged Britain's big four accountancy firms, KPMG, PwC, Deloitte and EY, accusing them of feasting on the carcass of Carillion and collecting more than £70 million in the process. Mr. Field's shock departure comes just 6 weeks after John Woodcock quit the party, blasting Mr. Corbyn's leadership, and has fueled fears the party will split. It comes after many weeks of Labour civil war over the anti-Semitism scandal, as Mr. Corbyn has been hit by a series of highly damaging allegations about his views and failure to tackle the racism festering among some of his members. In an excoriating attack on Labour under Mr. Corbyn, Mr. Field warned the party has been swamped with thuggish recruits who are bullying long-standing members. He said his resignation was a plea for action, and he desperately hopes that the party leadership will finally wake up and tackle the racism. But Mr. Field is refusing to quit as a Labour Party member, insisting that he will not be bullied and driven out of town and the party he has been a member of for 60 years. It means that he faces being expelled from the party within a fortnight, as the organisation's rules dictate that you cannot buy member in Parliament while not being a Labour MP. The Birkenhead MP was first elected in 1979 when Margaret Thatcher swooped into power, and continued as a Labour MP throughout the long years in the wilderness before Tony Blair's election. He saw off an attempt by far-left activists to deselect him in the 1980s, and he has faced a similar treat in recent months after he backed Brexit. Mr. Streeting tonight said that Labour members are being badly let down by the leadership's refusal to face down ugly characters who have been recruited to the party's ranks. He added, "The Labour leadership need to move pretty fast to avoid the catastrophic split in the Labour Party that we saw in the 1980s. Mr. Corbyn thanked Mr. Field for his decades of service. But the fight back among Corbyn loyalists kicked off immediately, with Labour sources claiming that the MP had been looking for an excuse to resign for some time. While Richard Bergen, the Shadow Justice Secretary and Corbyn loyalist, called for Mr. Field to fight a by-election so that voters have the opportunity to boot him out. The campaign against anti-Semitism organisation said Mr. Field's decision to resign was further evidence the Labour Party had become infested with anti-Semitism. Ewan Phillips, spokesman for the Labour Against Anti-Semitism campaign group, said, "The resignation of the Labour whip by Frank Field MP is a further sign that Jeremy Corbyn is failing to get to grips with the anti-Semitism crisis that has raged across the summer and engulfed his party. At a time when Labour should be providing a strong and credible opposition to Theresa May's government and fighting against a hard Brexit, we are instead seeing a senior Labour figure clash with Mr. Corbyn over his handling of a crisis that is not only shameful but is almost entirely of the leader's own making." He added, "Things must change. This situation cannot continue. If the Labour Party is to retain any semblance of its once proud reputation of anti-racism, then it is surely time for Mr. Corbyn to do the decent thing and resign." Mr. Field is the second Labour MP to resign the party whip and go independent in protest at Mr. Corbyn's leadership. He remains a card-carrying member of the party but will not follow orders from the whip's office. Who will be next to jump ship from Labour? Mike Gapes has told colleagues it is over for him. Luciana Berger has faced appalling abuse online. Wes Streeting is an outspoken critic of Mr. Corbyn. Kate Hoey faces deselection in her constituency. Margaret Hodge called Mr. Corbyn an anti-Semite. Chris Leslie is an arch critic of the Labour leader. Barrow MP Mr. Woodcock made the same move earlier this summer, and Mike Gapes, the Ilford South MP, has been the focus of speculation he could also resign. He told Mail Online tonight he was still an Labour MP. Labour leader Mr. Corbyn has been embroiled in anti-Semitism scandal for months, and last week Mail Online revealed footage of him dismissing British Zionists as not properly English. Mr. Field said this statement, and the former chief rabbi's condemnation of it, was the straw that broke the camel's back. He told Sky News, "The Jewish community in this country is desperately worried about our behavior, and I hope when the NEC meets in September that Jeremy will adopt the international definition on anti-Semitism." He also tore into thuggery and bullying carried out by Osmi of the influx of new members, but vowed to stay on in the party. He said, I'm not going to be run out of town by a group of people who have recently joined and until recently were standing against us. That's not the life for me. In his letter, Mr. Field said, I am resigning the whip for two principal reasons. The first centers on the latest example of Labour's leadership becoming a force for anti-Semitism in British politics. The latest example, from last week, comes after a series of attempts by Jeremy to deny the past statements and actions by him were anti-Semitic. Britain fought the Second World War to banish these views from our politics, but that superhuman effort and success is now under huge and sustained internal attack. In a letter to the party, it is thought Mr. Field blames the continuing row over Jeremy Corbyn and anti-Semitism for his decision. The leadership is doing nothing substantive to address this erosion of our core values. It saddens me to say that we are increasingly seen as a racist party. This issue alone compels me to resign the whip. Mr. Field also raised concerns about the thuggish conduct of some members in his local party and the lack of action against them. He said the party's actions serve to legitimize appalling levels of bullying and intimidation. Mr. Field said that he intended to continue representing Birkenhead in Westminster as an independent. He added, I also intend, Providence willing, to represent those views when the next election is called. A Labour Party spokesperson said, Jeremy Corbyn thanks Frank Field for his service to the Labour Party. A Labour source said, Frank has been looking for an excuse to resign for some time. Deputy leader Mr. Watson said, this is a serious loss to the party. It is a major wake-up call. We cannot afford to lose people of such weight and stature. The Campaign Against Anti-Semitism charity said Mr. Field's decision to resign was further evidence the Labour Party had become infested with anti-Semitism. Corbyn loyalist frontbencher says Frank Field should hold a by-election after shock resignation. A Labour frontbencher and Corbyn loyalist has said that Frank Field should hold a by-election after he quit a party whip. Mr. Field, who has been a Labour MP for nearly 40 years, announced he would now sit as an independent, blaming Jeremy Corbyn and the anti-Semitism scandal. But while other Labour MPs were paying tribute to Mr. Field's work, Richard Bergen said he should be forced to fight another election. The Shadow Justice Secretary tweeted, politicians who are elected as Labour MPs by their constituents and who then leave the Labour Party should do the right and respectful thing and call a by-election straight away. They should ask for their constituents' consent to continue to represent them on a different basis. Labour sources have since said that Field's wish to serve as an independent MP while remaining a member of the party is not possible. Under the Parliamentary Labour Party Standing Orders, which governs MPs, anyone who takes such action will usually get a letter asking them to retake the party whip within 14 days or face expulsion. Mr. Field is understood to be meeting the chief whip on Friday to discuss the matter further. Gideon Falter, chairman of the group, said, it is very sad that after almost 40 years as a Labour MP, Frank Field felt morally compelled to resign the Labour whip because the party that was fiercely anti-racist when he joined it has now become infested with anti-Semitism. He added, the indications are that others may now follow where Frank Field has led. Tory chairman Brandon Lewis said, Frank Field's resignation is a damning indictment of Jeremy Corbyn's total inability to take action against bullying and anti-Semitic racism within Labour. Despite promising a kinder politics, time and time again Corbyn has allowed people to get away with doing and saying things which have no place in public life. If other Labour MPs don't follow Frank Field's example, they are continuing to endorse Jeremy Corbyn's abject failure to act. Theresa May yesterday warned Mr. Corbyn that anti-Semitism is racism, as she demanded he finally act to stamp out vile abuse in Labour. The Prime Minister offered her backing to ex-Chief Rabbi Jonathan Sacks, who this week branded Mr. Corbyn an anti-Semite and compared him to Enoch Powell. Speaking in Nigeria during her tour of Africa, Mrs. May said Lord Sacks raised significant concerns and was only the latest to speak out. She said, I think the leader of the Labour Party needs to respond to those concerns. Yesterday he British Board of Deputies today wrote to Labour's General Secretary Jenny Formby with a renewed demand for action against anti-Semitism. Chief Executive Gillian Meron said it was beyond contention. Mr. Corbyn had shared platforms with anti-Semites and terrorist sympathisers. And she said a video revealed by Mail Online of Mr. Corbyn speaking in 2013 showed the Labour leader using a classic racist trope. A petition launched by the Campaign Against Anti-Semitism for Mr. Corbyn to resign has been signed by more than 30,000 people as the furious row continues to escalate. Mr. Corbyn is facing a fresh storm of controversy after Mail Online unearthed another video showing him accusing MPs of having their contributions to a debate written by the Israeli ambassador. Earlier this week, Lord Sachs, file image, said a tape of Mr. Corbyn attacking English Zionist Jews was the most offensive remark by a British politician since Enoch Powell's Rivers of Blood speech in 1968. Jews, including the Labour MP Luciana Berger, pictured, have repeatedly demanded Mr. Corbyn tackle anti-Semitism inside Labour in full. Frank Field's letter resigning from the Labour Party. Birkenhead MP Frank Field has written to Labour Chief Whip Nick Brown tendering his resignation from the party. This is his letter in full. Dear Nick, I am writing with considerable sadness to inform you of my intention to sit as an independent Labour Member of Parliament. I am resigning the whip for two principal reasons. The first centres on the latest example of Labour's leadership becoming a force for anti-Semitism in British politics. The latest example, from last week, comes after a series of attempts by Jeremy to deny that past statements and actions by him were anti-Semitic. Britain fought the Second World War to banish these views from our politics, but that superhuman effort and success is now under huge and sustained internal attack. The leadership is doing nothing substantive to address this erosion of our core values. It saddens me to say that we are increasingly seen as a racist party. This issue alone compels me to resign the whip. The second reason is that a culture of intolerance, nastiness and intimidation now reigns in too many parts of the party nationally and is sadly manifest within my own constituency Labour Party, CLP, in Birkenhead. This is, I fear, just one example of a phenomenon that has tightened its grip on CLPs across the country and is being driven, in part, by members who in previous years would never have been able to claim Labour Party membership. My original submission to the party on a specific bullying issue goes back 18 months. Many submissions have since come from me as well as from loyal party members. No decisive action has been taken. At best, the party's failure to act on these numerous complaints about the thuggish conduct of some members demonstrates a willful denial. At worst, it serves to legitimize appalling levels of bullying and intimidation of lifelong Labour supporters. You know that I wrote to the Labour Party 9 months ago about the atrocious behaviour of the then councillor Louise Riesehones. That Ms. Riesehones should not be a member of the party, let alone represent us in public positions, has been underscored by decisions taken by Wirral Council. As you know, she was found guilty of using her position as a councillor to intimidate members of the public. She has refused to apologise properly for her behaviour, and for breaching the council's code of conduct, even though one of those on the receiving end of her attack has only now a precarious hold on the livelihood. The charge sheet against this individual's suitability ever to hold office, let alone represent the Labour Party, has been detailed to you in separate correspondence. While she was withdrawn as a council candidate in Wallasey, she has still been able to join the party's shortlist for another seat and continues to hold an official position within the local party. I intend to continue to represent Birkenhead in Westminster, as I have had the honour to do so for almost 40 years, and I will continue to do so as an independent Labour member. I shall of course remain a party member as I have been since 1960. The values I have espoused during this time will be same that will continue to govern my conduct, and I also intend, providence willing, to represent those views when the next election is called. Few events would give me greater pleasure than to apply to the Parliamentary Labour Party for the whip. But great changes in the leadership's stance on the issues outlined in this letter will need to take place before I will be able to do so.